If you've never used Snapchat before, you're missing out on the 300 million other people sharing pictures and videos. Unlike other social media platforms, the app relies on quickly sending a message. Pictures can be set to last less than 10 seconds, without the pressure of collecting as many likes as possible or making content that's on par with the rest of the world. Snapchat users can talk casually to close friends with quick and silly photos and videos. With an estimated worth of $25 billion, the app's simplicity has fostered a new age of communication around the globe. Today, we're covering the history of Snapchat, its rise to fame, and the series of trials and mistakes it endured before returning to the coveted app everyone enjoys. Academic roots. Snapchat wasn't created by just anyone. Evan Spiegel was a Stanford University student majoring in engineering and product design. In April of 2011, a fraternity brother casually approached Spiegel with an idea. Sophomore Reggie Brown talked with his friends about his desire to erase embarrassing pictures he sent to people. Spiegel agreed and knew the idea could be taken much farther than a simple conversation. With the help of fellow engineer Bobby Murphy, a mobile sensation was born. The mathematical and computational science major put the app through development, and soon the three had a product to hold in their hands. Snapchat's creation wasn't the first time the three worked with one another. Living in the Kappa Sigma fraternity together, they tried their hands at another online startup beforehand. The trio invented Future Freshman, a college application platform designed to ease the process, but the idea was largely a flop. Now, with Brown's revolutionary idea and a collective excitement between the students, their newest idea was sure to be a success. In July 2011, the app was finished and launched in the App Store with the name Peekaboo. Instead of keeping every single image, the app, later renamed Snapchat, would wipe away pictures and videos within seconds. Murphy continues to act as chief technology officer, and he and Spiegel have most of the control over the digital sensation to this day. The idea was an almost instant hit. With images lasting up to 10 seconds, the site put a fast, addictive spin on online communication. Lucrative offer. The idea of a disappearing images app took the world by storm. Competing social media sites loved the idea of erasing simple and sometimes embarrassing pictures when they ran their course. Even so, what really helped Snapchat take off was its Snap Stories, allowing pictures and videos to linger for 24 hours for all to see. More popular users take advantage of this format to make sure all their followers catch a glance of their work. In 2013, Facebook gave Spiegel and the crew the offer of a lifetime, $3 billion for the wildly popular platform. With hundreds of millions of users taking 1 billion pictures every day, Mark Zuckerberg wanted in on the fast-paced nature of the app. The primarily young audience Snapchat attracts may have also inspired Zuckerberg to adopt a similar style and attract a more diverse audience. Unfortunately, Spiegel believed Snapchat was worth far more and turned down the offer. Bitter lasting impressions. In some social circles, Snapchat has a reputation worse for wear. Because images are supposedly deleted forever, users could send sensitive information or imagery to friends without anyone else seeing it. Unfortunately, the disappearing content may not have been gone for good. In late 2012, users increasingly found ways to preserve the pictures and videos they sent through the app by using third-party tools. As people were finding new ways to keep their content, a few users stumbled upon a disturbing secret. Every video they took was still stored in the app. Though wrapped in chains of code, videos were recovered one by one as users found a way to them. Snapchat was in hot water now. How could it preserve personal content without users knowing? Within months, the Snapchat crew encrypted the video files so they could no longer be recovered. The problem was discovered in December of 2012, but the issue was resolved as quickly as October 2013. Even years later though, that didn't stop larger organizations from criticizing some shady business practices. The Federal Trade Organization, or FTC, had been keeping tabs on Snapchat's behavior. They had issued several complaints on keeping user information. Even after videos were encrypted, sensitive photos were still being preserved and put on more permanent social media sites. Later on, Snapchat was hit with another lawsuit from the FTC for completely different reasons, To help find friends on the app, Snapchat would ask for the user's phone number to secretly gain access to their contact information. By pulling out friends' phone numbers, Snapchat could find out if they were associated with active users and connect them to one another. Eventually, Snapchat settled on the Sue and promised to adopt a more truthful and effective platform from then on. Each Sue provided an opportunity to improve. Despite its roadblocks, the app would remain popular and easy to use for teens and young adults, and continue to foster casual, friendly conversations. Inspiration. Many important Snapchat figureheads are put on a pedestal by fellow users. Over half of Snapchat users are between the ages of 13 and 24, so popular users are looked up to quite a bit by young, aspiring ones. The app fosters more than just personal relationships, though. Popular users like Sean McBride can make thousands of dollars off of just one post because of how many people are seeing them. McBride, better known as Sean Duras, became immensely popular with his Snapchat posts. Not only because of his impressive snowboarding and art skills, but because of his quick wit and cheerful personality. Quick bursts of information are just what companies need to get their messages across. Teaming up with popular users, companies like Disney, Nike, and Burger King ask uploaders like Sean Duras to feature their product or service at the forefront of their latest video. With millions of people seeing their favorite user engaging in a product, big companies gain a huge influx of customers because of short and sweet videos. In turn, Sean Duras and other big names are rewarded for their work. And their paychecks aren't small. Sean Duras and other users were soon noticed by the general public. The amount of hard work and time that went into every little video was astonishing. Sean Duras once went 38 hours without sleep to tour two different Disney theme parks for his audience. If it wasn't clear before, people around the world knew that Snapchat was no longer a place for casual or sneaky photo taking. It was a place where quick bits of information could shape the world, provide valuable information, advertising companies, and help users make a fortune. Update trauma. On February 9th, 2018, a new Snapchat update took the world by storm, but not in a good way. The platform redesigned its roster of people the user followed, separating close friends from popular uploaders. Instead of accessing everyone in the same place, people had to switch between what content they wanted to see. In a sense, the update made Snapchat less of a social media site and more of a text message alternative. With the means of unifying all types of users lost to the past, the app felt less like an easy gateway to see the goings-on of people around the world. Kylie Jenner is another highly popular Snapchat user, but her fame took the app in a different direction. Complaining about a new Snapchat update in 2018, her 24.5 million Twitter followers agreed with her stance and stopped using the app too. Jenner's simple series of tweets resulted in an unfathomable loss for Snapchat. Hours after she expressed her distaste for the update, the sheer number of users that left the app cost Snapchat $1.3 billion. Stock shares went down 6-7% too, and a petition to restore Snapchat to its former glory would soon garner 1.2 million signatures. Though the update was what caused grief for the site, it was a collective exchange of distaste towards the app that led to its devastating losses. The social media site wasn't a casual place for communication anymore. The app has become a pillar of modern communication whose changes inspire a wave of critique and social change. Return to success. The lawsuits, controversy, and negative petitioning certainly roughed up the platform. But despite a bumpy ride, the lingering users and addictive design still cater to a modern audience. Snapchat returned to a state of constant users. Every month, hundreds of millions of people are on the site posting pictures and sharing memories. The COVID-19 pandemic worked wonders for the company too. With everyone stuck inside, people were going crazy over a lack of social interaction. So what better way to communicate than with short-term pictures of a boring quarantine life? Users bonded over their collective suffering in a way, sending quick pics to relate to one another without the hassle of making sure the images were worthy of a huge following. In 2017, Spiegel decided to go public. Snap Inc. was now a player in the stock market, boasting an initial public offering of $24 billion. Within hours, the price of each stock skyrocketed, Starting at $17, the night of the release caused stocks to become more valuable, reaching highs of $26 per share. Now, the stock sits at a colossal $73 per share. In an effort to maintain its audience, every Snapchat update is carefully thought out. Each new feature doesn't try to change the app's layout, but instead introduces new tools to add to the experience. With a new in-app currency, scan tool, and TikTok participation, Snap Inc. is trying to broaden its audience without taking away from the simple social experience. With Evan Spiegel now living in a $100 million mansion in Los Angeles, I'd say he's doing a pretty good job keeping the app afloat. Conclusion: Snapchat isn't like other social media sites. In conjunction with more permanent platforms like Twitter and Instagram, Snapchat acts as a way to communicate on a more short-term personal level to strengthen relationships between close friends. Despite many painful hits, the app continues to stay strong with its unique platform and millions of popular users. The three developers currently stand at net worths of tens of billions of dollars, with a surge in popularity since 2020 and a plethora of new features. The work of three college sophomores 10 years ago has blossomed into something meaningful, lucrative, and life-changing. Today, the app fosters 200 million active daily users. Though not as popular as before, the numbers are still massive for a site less than a decade old. As controversy dies down and the need for social interaction persists on COVID-stricken Earth, Snapchat remains an important means of communication that will likely stick around for a while longer. Whether you have never used Snapchat or are a famous influencer, there is no doubting the world of fame and cash the app has conjured up. Whether you want to send a silly picture to your friends or give a quick update to loved ones, the app provides everything you need to level up your communication. All things considered, the Disappearing Images app acts as a marker for global change in the communication and money-making. The collective users forging their future and bonding with others shows just how important even the smallest and simplest tools can bring. Apparently, making a social media platform is the primary gateway to fame and fortune. So how can I get in on this action?